Welcome back to Curtis Rooney Stadium, District 9-5A battle, ready to roll. John Curtis, Brother Martin, from historic Rag Sherman Field to Curtis Rooney Stadium. And we're glad you've joined us. Here's the batting order for the John Curtis Christian Patriots under the direction of Coach Jeff Curtis, 14-5 overall and 3-0 in Catholic League play. Mason Mathurin leads off in left field. Cody Schechtsnyder is the second baseman. Daniel Cabrera in center field. Jake Curtis, the cleanup hitter at third base. Sean Bratz is at first base. Jordan Labruza, the shortstop. Trent Cormier, the designated hitter. Kyle Burns does the catching. Brandon Davis in right field. Ian Landreneau, the outstanding sophomore, does the pitching for Curtis. And the Patriots will oppose the outstanding left-hander of the Brother Martin Crusaders, Blair Frederick. Danny, the numbers speak volumes. He's simply outstanding.
Look at the strikeouts to innings pitch. 37 strikeouts and 23 innings pitch. He's electric on the mound. Play good defense behind him, and he's going to be a tough one for Curtis to solve here tonight.
Our weather tonight is, in a word, good. How's that? Flags blowing in a bit, 71 degrees. Mostly cloudy, but we're fine. The wind is out of the east, southeast at 10, so anytime you got that south wind, you know it's going to be blowing in just a little bit. Had a little bit of rain earlier this afternoon, but it's been good here since about 3:10, 3:15 this afternoon. I was here earlier and got that out of the way. We're ready to roll as Mason Mathurin will stand in from the right side to get things started for the Patriots. And the first pitch of the ball game is a fastball strike called. We're underway. Mathurin, good hitter. 3.44 the average. He's driven in 6 runs on the year. 0-1. And another fastball strike call. Frederick will pop that fastball, 88 to 92 consistently. Outstanding breaking ball to go along with it. 0-2. And he got him to chase a breaking ball. Picked up who guns him out for out number one. So good morning, good afternoon, good night. Mathurin disposed of, and Cody Schechtsnyder will bat.
That shows you the type of arm that John Curtis is up against tonight. Blair Frederick, 3 pitches, and sends Mathurin to the dugout.
One gone. Here's Cody Schechtsnyder at 260, a homer, and 14 driven in on the season. And another fast strike. Frederick looks sharp early with his fastball, getting ahead of hitters. Good look at Blair. Legacy player at Brother Rivers, was a very good player as well. This misses down and out for ball one. Primarily a 2-pitch guy, Danny. We'll see a changeup occasionally, but primarily fastball, breaking ball.
Yeah, he likes to throw that slider, too. That's what he just missed with on the outer part of the plate.
1-1. And crowds him. And it is 2 balls and a strike.
Good arm that the Tigers in Baton Rouge are going to pick up when this man steps on campus.
Way outside low, bounced away from Stretzinger, and now 3-1 to Schechtsnyder. Infield playing him straight up, normal depth outfield. Fairly shallow in center and right. Average depth in left, the 3-1. And a fastball strike, top of the strike zone. Calls him back, and it's 3-2. Don't want to flip the bat away. I know it's an automatic reaction. You don't need to sell it. You need to be the buyer, not the seller, in that circumstance. Say it all the time. Easy for me to say. You're the coach. And that's low. So that time, flip it, trot down to first, the one-out walk issued to Schechtsnyder.
Yeah, just wait a second. Let that umpire make his call and then react to it. They're not too crazy about that when you start down the line.
And here is Daniel Cabrera, the superb two-way player for the Patriots. Left-handed swinger, the junior at 455, 2 homers, 14 driven in. Breaking ball, strike call. This could be a matchup of future teammates at LSU. Both have committed. Cabrera stepped out. Just the batting glove back in. Starting pitcher in their victory over Rummel this past weekend. This one missing away. It's 1-1.
Needs to locate down. Does Blair Frederick. You don't want to pitch up in the zone of this young man. Cabrera can make it hurt.
1 ball and 1 strike. Cabrera waiting patiently, left side. And the pitch. Fastball just low. two balls and a strike. His kid commands the strike zone very well. It's one of the things you note about Cabrera, the maturity as a hitter. Just a quick bat, hits to all fields with power. 2-1 the count. Short lead by and a swing and a foul out of play left side. Heated him up. Cabrera a bit behind, and it's 2-2.
A big spot right here, 2-2 pitch. You know, you would expect to see Blair Frederick come with something that he thinks can retire Cabrera. It'd be nice for Brother Martin to be able to get to two outs right here.
2-2 the count, ready now. Another. Taps it slowly, foul, third base side. And Stretzinger just got there in time to keep it foul. And it's a good thing he did. That ball was slicing back toward the line.
That ball was absolutely going to come back into fair territory. Heads up play there by senior catcher Kevin Stretzinger to really use his speed, if you will, to knock that one before it came back, because it was definitely rolling back into fair territory.
Holding it 2-2 as Cabrera, beating it down the line, comes back to reclaim his stick, ready to stand in. Rommel kept him in check in their game this past Saturday, but the Rommel starter, Luke Lacoste, has an outstanding changeup and breaking ball, and he really didn't give in to Cabrera. Frederick has an outstanding fastball, though, and he got him with a terrific hook. Beautiful pitch, and that's out number two. Quality stuff from Blair Frederick.
That was a big-time pitch there to throw that breaking ball against a hitter like Cabrera to get that out. Now you're sitting at two outs. You're a pitch away from getting out of the inning. That was a big hitter to retire in this Curtis lineup.
Just a perfect pitch.
Completely froze Cabrera there. Nothing he could do. Just a great pitch. Tip your cap and head back to the dugout.
Here's Jay Curtis. Jay, look out, lashes it foul toward the Curtis dugout, late on the fastball. Jay, an outstanding hitter, outstanding T-Sport star. Superb for the Curtis football team as well. He's at 386, no homer, and 20 for Jay, and yet another sophomore. There are so many underclassmen on this Curtis team. Some future they have. 0-1, swing and a miss, threw the fastball by him. That's power against power. Fastball and a big cut. Love those matchups.
Power on power right there.
Oh, 2. Threw it by him with heat. Struck out the side. A walk mixed in. Frederick's got his A game early in this one. And on to the bottom of the first as Brother Martin comes to the plate with no score. Frederick throwing hard, Danny. You can immediately. Really threw hard there.
Yeah, he did. That was a nice inning. Other than the one walk, he did a really nice job of commanding multiple pitches. You could see the special type of fastball that he has. And then really the most impressive pitch was the breaking ball to retire Cabrera.
And it's time now for our batting order for the Brother Martin Crusaders, presented by First NBC Bank. Blair Frederick appropriately leads it off. Mason Bonifons is the third baseman. Kevin Stretzinger, the catcher. Chase Dolly is at first base. Michael Kirsch, the shortstop. Jared Tassin, the designated hitter. Joel Bergeron, the second baseman. It's Alex Guidry in right field. Brady Faust, outstanding freshman in left field. Hunter Lynn plays center field, does not bat for the Crusaders. And they will oppose yet another outstanding sophomore, Ian Landrino, for the Patriots. And the numbers on him are equally impressive. Danny, this kid is mature for his age, and he's a three-pitch guy.
He is a three-pitch guy, always difficult at the high school level when a guy can throw three pitches for strikes, and this young man can do it. Shout out to Jesuit Blue Jays in his last Catholic League start. So he's feeling good. He's feeling confident about where he is as an arm in this John Curtis rotation. He'll be tougher on Brother Martin here tonight.
Outstanding performance in his shutout of Jesuit. The numbers are superb, reflecting just how good he is and what a future he has. 6 foot, 170 pounds. And Frederick will start it. Here's Frederick, another outstanding two-way performer. Frederick standing in left side at 357, 8 driven in. And he took a strike called over the outside edge. They play Frederick as a dead pull hitter. Infield and outfield. Second baseman cheats over toward the hole. Center fielder way over. Cabrera in the right center. Threw it by him. And it's 0-2.
Landrino pounding the zone here thus far. That's what you like if you're Jeff Curtis.
The 0-2. And he got him looking outside corner fastball for out number one. Exactly the same way that Blair Frederick started his half inning. Good morning, good afternoon, good night.
Spotted up on the outer part of the plate. Frederick took it and got the call. I think Brother Martin thought that was a little bit off that outside part of the plate, but hey, the umpire says it's there, it's there, and we move on.
Strike called to Bonifons, the third baseman at 3-0-2. He's driven in 11. Bounced that one, it's 1-1. And again, they play him to pull. One ball and one strike. Landrino steps off. There's a strike called, and it's 1-2. One ball and two strikes. As mentioned, they're playing in the pull, as they have for both hitters that are. Here's the 1-2 pitch. Breaking ball beat toward first. That is a foul ball, just foul. As Brett's tried to get there, that thing hugging the line, very close, but called foul. And it holds at 1-2. Again, two-man crew. And both umpires positioned perfectly to make that call.
Very, very tight there. Very close, and that was a break for Brother Martin for sure.
Landrino delivers. Just missed the outside edge, 2-2. Let me mention this about Kyle Burns behind the plate. He has very soft hands, very good receiver. He will steal strikes frequently. I saw that in the game we did this past Saturday on radio. This is down a ball, 3-2. Really good catcher. And when I talk about stealing strikes, all about how he receives the ball. Very soft hands, and he will move that glove beautifully, receiving the ball to make pitches look good all the time. Might have gotten one on the first hitter in this game.
Very good chance of that. Always important.
That's high, and you can see how he tried to frame that, catching it upside down to make it look better because it was high, and it's a walk. And Bonifons trots to first. Good indication of what we're referencing. A good look at Kyle Burns. Good catchers make such a difference at every level. Here is Kevin Stretzinger, speaking of good catchers. Quick move to first. Brett's a slap tag, so Landrino immediately shows a pretty good move.
And that was a nice job there by Mason Bonifons to draw that walk, get a guy on, and try to bring up the meat of their order with runners on base.
Stretzinger, 356, as Bonifons gets dirty once again. Stretzinger, three home runs, big power, 15 driven in, and they play him to pull. See how Burns receives it so softly. I mean, he makes everything look pretty good. Just missing away for ball one. Curtis looking for the double play ball. Stretzinger hopes to do some damage. Quick move again. Safe at first. And Landrino with a good move to first base. Runner goes. Hit and run. Popped up right field. Davis back. Wynn working on that ball. He makes the catch, though, for the out. No tag. As the runner was moving on the pitch, and that's out number two.
Well, Stretzinger had the right idea of trying to take it the other way there, but up underneath it, lifted it, and Bonifons has to return to first. So here comes Chase Dolly with two down. Brother Martin trying to go a little hit and run there, but just got it up in the air, and it's not what you're looking for in a hit and run situation.
Didn't barrel it up. That got toward the, a little bit toward the hands. Runner goes, pitches high, throw by Burns is right on the money. He is. Did he drop it or hold it? He dropped it. Safe at second base. Throw is right there by Burns, but unable to hold on to make the play with Schechtsteiner. Collision there as the runner arrived pretty much at the same time, but a good throw by Burns.
A good jump there by Bonifons, a good throw by Burns. There you see Mason Bonifons going in hard. The ball comes out. He is safe. So Jeff Lupo wasn't able to get anything going with that hit and run that he tried with Stretzinger. So he goes with the straight steal, and Bonifons now in scoring position for Brother Martin.
It's a Brother Martin team that likes to run. That's their 33rd stolen base in 37 attempts this season. There's the 1-0 pitch. Breaking ball is a dandy for a strike called to Dolly. He's at 260 with two homers and 19 RBI.
And it's only the first in and bottom of the first, but in games like this, you get guys in scoring position. You got to try to get them in.
fooled by that breaking ball, and it's 1-2.
You know, you would expect this to be a tight, low-scoring type of game. This is an opportunity for Brother Martin to try to get a big two-out hit early on, a chance for Landrino to try to shut it down.
Missed down and out. It's 2-2. So two balls and two strikes to Chase Dolly. Bonifon's trying to get as big a lead as he can. Hoping to score on a base hit. Dolly hits it hard, deep short. Nice sliding stop. Gets up, made the throw, and safe at first. And a run scores, and Brother Martin takes a 1-0 lead.
Heads up, base running there by Mason Bonifons with two outs. He didn't stop. You read the bobble and keep on trucking, and that's a big run. That's one of the things we talked about. With two outs, being able to score, guys, is huge in a game like this. Ground ball deep in the hole. LaBruzza makes a nice play, skips it over there. Brett's not able to come up with the pick, and Bonifon just keeps on trucking. Good base running by the Crusaders.
Unquestionably. Basically stole the run. LaBruzza made a good play to get there. His throw short up. Brett's, as you mentioned, a very tough one to pick. And just aggressive base running got him there. There's another great move by Landrino. Boy, he's very good to first base. Just back. It was Dolly. So a 1-0 lead for Brother Martin early in this one. Blair Frederick doesn't need much. Foul back to the screen. A good pass at that ball by Kirsch. A two-lane commit at 143, a homer and nine driven in. This is a kid that has the tools. And you just know that the numbers are going to come at some point. As that does not reflect his ability. Another quick move to first.
Well, the better teams that respect Michael Kirsch for the player that he is, they're going to pitch him away. They're going to work away. They're going to nibble around that outer third. He's really got to get committed to hitting the baseball to the opposite field.
And a good off-speed pitch drops in there, and it's 0-2. No balls and two strikes on Kirsch. We've seen a lot of breaking balls this year in the games we've seen.
Well, that's what happens when you're a good player. They're careful with you. They have a plan of attack when they have to pitch. So you have to do a good job, as he takes a breaking ball there, but you have to do a good job of distinguishing pitches to hit, laying off of breaking balls and pitches that really aren't advantageous to you as a hitter early in the count.
Fastball away, delayed steal, throw by Burns, and he is out at second base. So the delayed steal this time comes up empty. Good tag on the pick. And the inning, a run on no hits and error, nobody left. After one, Brother Martin 1-0 over John Curtis on the first NBC Bank Prep Showcase. This portion of the first NBC Bank Prep Showcase is presented by Joseph A. Bank, the new tradition since 1905. In Metairie and in Mandeville. 1-0 Crusaders as we go to the second inning. Blair Frederick, 18 pitches in the first, 12 strikes. He struck out the side and walked one. He faces Sean Bretz to start the second. And he delivers low to Bretz, who will be followed by and Cormier. Bretz at 255 with a home run and 9 RBI for the huge first baseman, the 6'5", 220-pound senior for the Curtis Patriots. There's the 1-0 pitch. And that's a strike called. It's 1-1. It's a pleasure to welcome to our broadcast position my good friend, JT Curtis. JT, I hope you had a wonderful, blessed Easter, man.
It was. I tell you what, it's such a wonderful time to celebrate the resurrection of Christ and what he means in our lives. And it was. It was good to be with family and friends and to celebrate Easter Sunday.
2-1 pitch. Brett's toward right, hit it well. Right fielder on the run will never get there. To the wall it goes. Sean Brett's on his way to second. He will be standing there with a leadoff double in the second inning.
That's a great way for John Curtis to respond. That's always what you're looking to do there. Your opponent scores. You want to come right back and score. Brett's just absolutely drills this ball deep to right field at Kirsch Rooney over Guidry's head. He had to turn and go into chase mode pretty quickly, so John Curtis opens up the second in a nice way with a big double by Brett's.
JT, obviously you are not surprised by this 3-0 start in this outstanding league. Curtis is an outstanding baseball program in its own right.
Well, we have been for a lot of years, and of course we've played a lot of these teams through the years and know the competitiveness of the league.
Having a chance to play in this league, and you did it in football this year, I think it was everything you expected. It was good competition week to week, good sportsmanship, quality institutions, good crowds. This is everything you want, isn't it?
Well, it's what high school sports should be about. And in general, this league has been a real pleasure to be in. I have played in a lot of leagues, obviously, through the years. But I think they would by far conduct their business as professional as you can do it. And it's been a real pleasure to be with them.
0-2. Just missed the outside edge with a heater, and it's 1-2 on LaBruza. He's driven 18 on the year. Good look at Blair Frederick, who, again, is heading to LSU next year. Pitching with a one-run lead here in the second inning. Curtis with the leadoff man in scoring position. LaBruza would like to at least get him over the 1-2. And, oh, he just missed. Home plate umpire flinched on the backdoor breaker, and it's 2-2. That's either a good take or a whew, thank you very much. 2-2 the count. LaBruza, good player. Frederick from the belt to the plate. And pops it right side. On the run, the right fielder Guidry is there. Makes the catch, tag from second, but no advance by Bretz. As Guidry hustles it back in. And out number one here in the second with Trent Cormier coming to the plate.
Coach had a pretty big change. Johnny gets the opportunity to go up to Ball State as a linebacker's coach. And Jeff has to take over your baseball program. Johnny was at the helm for a while, and now Jeff's running things on the diamond for you.
Well, you know, they both worked together so closely through the years and of course, had an opportunity to play with each other for a lifetime. So they know each other very well. And although it was not exactly what we wanted to have happen, it was a smooth transition. And Steve Curtis stepped in and is an assistant coach along with Cal Pierce. And they've done a nice job of really just keeping his team focused on what they're capable of doing early in the season.
Jeff Curtis now in control, running things down at third. And there's a pitch high and away. 1-1 to Cormier with a runner at second and one out. And again, the opportunity to move up to 5A was presented to you. You accepted it. I know you thought it might be something that would help in the healing process with this association. Unfortunately, that's not been the case. Here's a foul ball out of play, and I say unfortunately because I'm unabashed in my support of everybody being together, and I know you feel the same way.
Well, exactly. And you know, we heard for years that the problem was between Evangel and us and all the humbug that was over the years. Well, we eliminated that. And I think it became evident that that is not really the problem. The problem is about competitiveness of spirit. And it is not single to us or to Evangel, but to teams that are successful and that work hard to be successful. And that's disappointing in our state.
As Frederick records his fourth strikeout, blowing away Cormier with a fastball. And now Kyle Burns will bat the catcher at 208, has three driven in. Runner at second. Bretz was there with no outs. He's still there with two outs. And they'll play this hitter to hit to the off field. Pitch to Burns. That's a strike over the outside edge. Burns stands a little bit off the plate from the right side. So they might try to work that outside on him. Boys, kid's a really good catcher. I was just talking to Danny about how impressed I am with him defensively.
He is a good player. Of course, he was an offensive guard for us in football. His dad played for us, both in football and baseball. And just happens to be my dentist at the same time. So It's been a long relationship with the Burns family, and they're excellent people. But he does a great job defensively. You know, unfortunately, in the Rumble game, he broke his ankle in the first quarter and was
Here's
able
a ground ball
to,
right side. Hold that thought, JT. Handled by Bergeron, who throws him out. Stay with us for a half inning, if you will.
We will.
As the Patriots threaten but cannot score with a hit. They strand their second. Bottom of the second coming. And it remains Brother Martin on top of John Curtis, 1-0. Time now for Traditions, presented by Joseph A. Bank, the new tradition since 1905. The Curtis family tradition isn't just about the Patriots football program. It applies in baseball as well. JT handed the reins to his oldest son, Johnny, and now the tag team has brought in Jeff. Johnny handed it off to his younger brother. So the Curtis family legacy, except for that first guy. These guys have been unbelievable. I mean, I don't know. I guess they couldn't find a baseball coach, you know. Took them all that time, Danny. They finally found one, right? Johnny came in and really got it done. Just kidding, JT. I don't think people realize, Danny, just how good the Curtis baseball program was under JT Curtis.
Absolutely. I believe, Coach, correct me if I'm wrong, but a lot of 4A state championships. I remember when I was playing at Jesuit, late 90-ish, you know, late 90s. You guys were a very quality program, winning the Class 4A state
we did.
Championship
we did.
At that time.
Won our first championship in 82 as a double-A team, and we've seen six since then, and at both the 2A, 3A, and 4A level, and have been very competitive in baseball and have had some awfully good players through the years, and really proud of our baseball program and how they compete.
Jared Tassan takes low after Michael Kirsch popped out to the pitcher Landrino to start the inning. Tassan at 286 with eight driven in, right-handed swinger, serving as the DH. And time was called just before the pitch was made. Landrino wants to work quickly, and he delivered that one right down the pipe, but time had been granted as we're in the bottom of the second. A 1-0 lead for the Crusaders. Good breaking ball dips low.
Coach, you had mentioned that you've played in a lot of leagues over the years, a lot of districts. Kind of interested in asking you this. Was there a different kind of buzz on campus this year, knowing that, you know, especially football season, you had Brother Martin coming, you had Jesuit coming that Friday night, whatever it may have been, just the step up, so to speak. Was there a different buzz on campus?
Yeah, I think so. And a part of it was because so many of these kids know each other, you know, and they played against each other in rec ball and grew up playing some travel ball against one another. So it really was. I think it really created some excitement, not only at school, but among alumni and in the workplace. I understand there was one or two arguments through the course of the season. A few dinners that went back and forth, but that's good. You know, it's what high school ball should be about, and it should be competitive. It should be great sportsmanship, and it create a lot of family fun. And I'm sincerely believe that this is a sport that the family can come to. If you look out at this crowd tonight, there are a lot of moms and dads and brothers and sisters, and that's what it should be.
No question, a foul ball makes it 1-1 on Joel Bergeron, who's a 306 hitter with seven driven in. And out to the mound goes Burns, and both coaches coming to confer with the home plate umpire. That one got a piece of him, but he looks to be okay. You could hear it with our microphones, picked it up pretty clearly. It's always a good move. And, of course, one coach doesn't want to be usurped by the other. So one coach shows interest in the umpire, the other will as well. Nice move, Jeff. And Wiz, this one missing down. It's 2-1. You always have to show respect to Blue, right?
Well, no question. And just what we said, a little competitive edge there. Want to make sure that he gets his 2 cents in if the other one is going to get his.
This is going to come down eventually. The catcher, Burns, coming back and up against the screen. So it holds 2 balls and 2 strikes on Bergeron with 2 outs, nobody on here in the third inning. Yeah, I think the biggest story in closing out that whole thought about the new league and classification is that I knew, and I told you this a year ago, you'd have really good relationships, you'd have spirited competitive contests, but you'd have as clean a games and as good a competition as you could find, and immense respect amongst each other. That's exactly what's happened.
Well, it has, and to put
it's
it
a hard hit ball for a base hit into the gap. Is he going to be able to cut it off to hold him to one? Rounding first, heading for second, and stopping there with a single. Is Bergeron. Good job to get to it by Davis to keep him to a single.
Hi, we have good speed in the outfield. You're going to have to hit it hard in the gap to get that extra base on us. We do run really well in the outfield, and that still was a good play by him. But, you know, the thing about it, after one of our meetings just recently, Dave Morrow and I were walking back to the car, and he said, Coach, has it been what you expected? And I said, Dave, that and more. And he said, well, we've enjoyed having you in the league, too. It's just, I think it's helped everybody concerned. And I think that was the right sentiment from both of our perspectives. A lot of class, a lot of competitiveness, and a lot of goodwill.
And most of the fans are good about it, too.
Yeah, they are. They really are. And like I said, there was a few dinner exchanges in the workplace, and that's a good thing. It brings a little liveliness to Monday through Friday, and Friday night it got competitive.
No balls and a strike and a toss to first. Runner back. As Bergeron is there with a 2-out single here, 1-0 Crusaders in the bottom of the second, visiting with JT Curtis of the John Curtis Patriots. Runner goes, and the pitch is popped up in the right center. Davis should get there. He's under it. He'll put it away. With a hit, they strand a runner. Their first left. JT, thank you so much for joining us. We'll let you get down to join your son and enjoy the rest of the game and get away from that other guy. Thank you, Coach. Appreciate it. Back in a moment. Seven. Okay. Thank you, man. Appreciate it, man. Yeah. This portion of the first NBC Bank Prep Showcase is presented by Delery Camarda Realtors, dedicated to going the extra mile to help you make the most of your real estate experience. Call 504-875-3555 or visit NolaHomeFinder.com.
I'd like to thank Ann Camarda and Joyce Delery for their continued support. They've been with us as a sponsor of the showcase since day one, and we appreciate their continued support of high school athletics.
0-1 the count to Brandon Davis, who was a hero this past Saturday. And this time Frederick throws the fastball by him, and it's 0-2. Davis had the game-winning sacrifice fly in the bottom of the sixth as Curtis rallied past Rummel 3-2 in a thriller. Here's the 0-2. Threw 3 fastballs by him, and that's Blair Frederick at his best, just overpowering the hitter for out number one, his 5th strike out of the game.
One of the top arms you'll anywhere in this state. There's a reason that he's going to pitch at LSU. You're seeing it right here tonight. First time through the Curtis order. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 strikeouts. So really impressive start the first time through.
Mason Mathern struck out his first time swinging. And there's a pitch that just missed the outside edge of the slider. It's 1-0.
He's done a nice job of keeping the ball down in the zone, hitting that outside corner with that good fastball. As you mentioned, Ken, upper 80s, can touch into the 90, low 90 area.
This is hard hit to right, but foul. As Mathern sliced it down the right side.
And that's the thing with Brother Martin. It's going to make them dangerous in this league and dangerous in the playoffs, especially when you get into the two out of three series, is the fact that they have two aces, one from the left side, one from the right side, with Frederick and Keegan Gillis.
Two balls and a strike. Threw it by him, down and out, 2-2.
Retired Mathern. Three pitches in that first at bat to get the game started here tonight.
And just powdered him. Outside edge, threw it by him. Strikeout number 6 for Blair Frederick, and 2 gone here in the third for Curtis.
Second baseman, Cody.
2-2 pitch, that's where, as a pitcher, you want to come with your out pitch, so to speak. He came with the fastball, and as you mentioned, just powdered it, threw it hard right there in that outside corner.
Schechnider walked his first trip, takes a hot one inside. Well, Frederick lost his last start, but he threw the ball extremely well. The loss had nothing to do with his pitching. Missing away 2-0, he faced a pitcher who pitched extremely well against him that night, and a team that played rock solid defense while his betrayed him just a bit. That's a strike called. It's 2-1. And in this league, it really does come down to who makes the plays, because typically speaking, the pitching is pretty good in this league and the defense is pretty good. And that's a strike called, so it's 2-2.
Ran that fastball right in on the inner third. So he's doing a nice job of putting the fastball where he wants it. Then he's also got that breaking ball with there. There's a slider that he tried to backdoor him right on the outside corner and get the call.
Three balls and two strikes. Frederick tugs at the cap, takes a deep breath, ready. Payoff pitch on the way. And he missed inside, so Schechnider, for the second consecutive time, has drawn a walk from Frederick. The only two walks he's issued. And he trots to first with two outs, and that gets Cabrera to the plate, which is always important for Curtis to get him up there with someone on base.
That's important, too, Curtis, just to get him in the stretch. I mean, Frederick's really good either way, but most of the time a pitcher does lose a little something when you get him in the stretch. So never hurts to try to get a guy on, get Blair in the stretch, see if you can try to put something together offensively.
Throw to first, Schechnider back. Frederick very tough to run on. Swing and a miss. Good breaking ball to Cabrera. Clearly looking fastball, and he got the slider. And it came up empty. And Cabrera has to get used to it. I mean, like I said, in the game I saw over the weekend, they fed him change up after breaking ball throughout. And he got the slider there. And again, remember, first time up, he was frozen by a breaking ball for a call strike 3. As a hitter, you have to adjust. Tough to do so against a guy that throws hard, though. 0-1. Another good breaking ball for a strike call. That's 0-2. Well, he's got both pitches working extremely well, the fastball and slider. No balls and two strikes. Frederick with the 0-2. Fastball away, so he showed him that pitch. And what I mean by that is he did not mean to throw it for a strike. He simply wanted to establish that I've got it when I need it. And now I'm probably going to go to my money pitch to get you out. 1-2 the count. And he hits it middle of the diamond. Nice pick. Stepping on second, Kirsch. Good play by Kirsch. And the inning is over. And no runs, no hits. And a runner stranded there. Third left. Bottom of the third. Brother Martin leads Curtis 1-0. Our fact of the game is brought to you by Delery Camarda Realtors. John Curtis and Brother Martin were the only New Orleans area baseball teams to reach the state semifinals in 2015. Brother Martin in 5A, John Curtis went on to win the 3A state championship as they took down Parkview Baptist. And these are two quality programs now together in the same league. Adjusting the base at second base. It popped out of there on that last play to end the top of the third. So they're doing some nice groundwork to make sure it is secured. Thus a very slight delay before we resume play. Here in the bottom of the third inning with Brother Martin on top, 1-0. Along with Danny Ream, I'm Ken Trahan. A good view of the grandstand at Kirsch Rooney and a good view of Ian Landreneau, who has thrown 32 pitches in two innings. He's walked one, he struck out one. Freddie Faust leads it off. And what a terrific kid this is. Pitch down and away for ball one. Faust, the numbers speak for themselves. 400 hitter, two RBI for Brady. And he's got some legacy himself. Missing low, 2-0. His uncle sitting pretty close by here, who happens to be the dean here at Delgado of baseball, the head coach, Joe Sherman, and of course his father, Doug Faust, an outstanding coach. And there you go. On the outfield line, Gene Faust was a phenomenal coach in his own right. Great legacy in this town. Remember him very well. St. Bernard Parish when I was young. And also it's 3-1. And of course, Doug Faust, now the head coach at Loyola University. And this is Brady's son, and what a future he has in front of him. Just a freshman, and he's on. Such a disciplined hitter with a beautiful swing. He's down at first, so people are asking, okay, he's that good. He's batting 400. He's batting ninth. Well, I think it's a good move by Mark Wisniewski. Don't put too much pressure on the youngster at this stage, but at the same time, there's no way you're keeping him out of the lineup.
No, they're taking time. They don't want to throw him right into the middle of the fire just yet, but it's probably going to happen. You know, they're starting to kind of look at some things here just because he's playing so well. Yep. As you mentioned, hitting 400, and he plays. He's very mature for his age. He plays like a much older player, great approach. Nothing seems to bother him. He's done a great job for Brother Martin in the nine hole, and if that continues, I think you'll see him go into some different roles offensively.
A couple of moves to first and yet another by Landreneau. Frederick at the plate. Struck out looking his first time and could bunt, could swing. Hit and run's a possibility. Big hole through the right side. He is bunting, but he takes a ball. Nice block by Burke. Again, I'm going to keep saying it. You're going to really like this guy behind the plate. He does everything well. 1-0 the count.
As the old saying goes, you got to be strong up the middle. All starts with that catcher position. So Burns and Stretzinger and Martin's side gives both of these clubs two real good catchers.
Again, just take note, as Jeff Curtis will visit the mound, 2-0. When he receives that pitch that's up in the zone, he's always going to have the glove facing down to try to make the pitch look lower than it is. And when the pitch is down, he's going to be underneath it and making it look better up. And the same thing on the corners where he frames it well. That's what good catchers are able to do. And when you say soft hands and receiving the ball, it's all about making sure you don't snatch at it, because when you do that, you're going to really hurt yourself in terms of getting calls from the home plate umpire. So the Patriot visit on the mound taking place with Jeff Curtis talking it over. If you are interested in purchasing a DVD copy of today's game, send an email to prep@sportsnola.com or call our offices at 504-681-0120 during normal business hours. You will receive a reply with more information on purchasing DVDs. 2-0 the count. And as if on cue, there's the strike call, and it came on an off-speed pitch. Two balls and a strike to Frederick. Let's see if Brother Martin put something on here. Good count to try to do so, and a good combination with Frederick and Faust. There he goes. And it's a fly ball a mile high in the left field. So Mathurin, coasting under it, is going to be there and put it away for out number one, and Faust returns to first. So twice they've tried to put the hit and run on, but twice they've hit the ball in the air.
Key to a hit and run is you want to try to hit it hard on the ground somewhere. You get those infielders moving. They're starting to make their breaks to go cover the bag on the steal attempt, and you like to be able to hit something hard, get it through the infield, possibly go first to third. That's the idea. But Brother Martin, both times they've tried it, with Stretzinger and then there with Frederick, they've lifted the ball up in the air
And here's ball one delivered to Bonifaz, who walked and scored the Brella Martin run. Outstanding base running back in the first inning. He stole the base and then took home on a throw in the dirt. Very aggressive base running. And here chops one foul first base side. And it's 1-1.
There's a good look at Mason. Really fine young man. He's doing a nice job. Brella Martin over at the hot corner over at third this year. Hitting in the two hole. Great family.
Throw to first, close again. Runner back.
There's Mike Capo down at first base for Brella Martin. He's the first base coach. Jeff Lupo over at third. Mark Wisniewski, the head coach, and Todd Rhodes are in the dugout.
Yeah, there's a good off-speed pitch for a strike called, and it's 1-2. One and two the count. Here's another way high, and it's 2-2. Two balls and two strikes.
There's Mark Wisniewski, the dean of the Catholic League, longest tenured head coach in the district. First season as head coach at Brella Martin was 1997.
Nice play by Bretz, but it's foul. Boy, that could have been a double play. What a play by Bretz. But called foul immediately by the home plate umpire. That's the second one that's been about as close as you can get, Danny. And that was a really good play by Bretz. And Jeff Curtis is still going out there to talk about it. He's asking, are you sure? Two or three times. A good look at the head coaching positions in the Catholic League. And Wisniewski, Danny continues to call him the dean. And he's wincing when he hears that. Joey Latino and Nick Moss. Longest tenure guys, and they're 6 years in. It's a good list of coaches, though. Kirk Bullinger, of course, Cass Hargis, new on the job, Ryan Sims. Good coaching tree. Well, it was very close, wasn't it? Wow. That is a tough call. Either way, you can understand it.
Well, it's all going to go off of where the baseball is, not where the position player is when he catches it. It's where the position of the ball is. So the home plate umpire felt like the position of the ball was on the foul side of the line and called it a foul ball. But once again, another tight play. And I believe it was Bonifaz's at bat the last go around that we had another really tight call right up along that first base side.
And again, the second base bag has become uprooted, and they're going to stop play to try to get this repaired. And Joe Sherman himself is going to go out there to try to do some groundwork and shovel some dirt and get that the way it needs to be. It's a dangerous thing when that base is dislodged like that. So, again, a look at Joe Sherman at his very best, doing what he does best, right? I couldn't help but say that. Just kidding. Marvelous guy, and of course does a fantastic job with this facility on behalf of high school baseball and the greater New Orleans area, and does a great job with his program at Delgado. College World Series, two straight years and counting. Big series coming up with LSU Eunice this weekend. And he's in his catcher's squad right now, taking care of business, man. I didn't know he could still do it. Still not to his liking, you could tell right there when he looked at it. And he's studying to see exactly what the problem is. And now Jeff Curtis has a shovel. He's ready to do some work.
All hands on deck.
All hands on deck.
They're ready to go.
Wisniewski says, hey, if you can do this, I can do it too. So just think about that coaching brain trust right there.
Base umpire Shane Rigdon's out there making sure that they're doing things the right way. I guess that's his job.
Huh? Way to go, Shane.
Shane's out there overlooking things while Joe Sherman digs away. You know, but that's what happens with the plugs. You know, the mud will get down in there, and the base just can't get down far enough to be flush against the ground, and you take the chance of it being shaky and wobbly, and it looks like it might still be a little wobbly.
A little
second
bit.
Second base being a little difficult here tonight.
I think they're trying to get some dirt to help mount that base surrounding it, because I think there's a little bit of a divot right now. So the plug might be in there fairly well, but not to Joe Sherman's liking. But then they also have to surround it with dirt, so he's going to continue to work on that as we speak. It's a science, isn't it? Well, maybe not.
I don't know about all that. But
you're the coach, man. Come on, dude. Pick me up on this, man. Let's take a break here. So we are in the bottom of the third inning, 1-0 lead for Brother Martin over John Curtis. Back in a moment with more from Coach Looney Stadium. Of a grin on his face. Okay, I got it done. We know you're good. Thank you, buddy. We appreciate you very much. As second base is secured, and we're ready to resume play with a 2-2 count on Mason Bonifons. And Brady Faust at first base with one out. In a 1-0 game, bottom of the third, Brother Martin on top. And the runner goes, and a swing and a drive to right. Is it high? It's hit deep. Is it fair? The answer is no. Just foul. Up against the wall at the 325 side. Bonifons just hooked it foul by no more than about 3 feet.
Ball was hit extremely well. Pulled it a little bit too much, but Mason got the bat head out. There you see it. He really turned on that one. Gave that ball a rise. A little bit too much in the foul territory there, and he'll have to come back and try to do it again.
Great job by our cameraman. 2 or 3 feet is all it was. Right at the 325 sign, and now high and away, and 3-2. And you can bet that Brady Faust is going to be off on this pitch. Brother Martin's been very aggressive. He's stolen a base and had one runner caught stealing thus far. And not going. And the pitch is high. Ball four. I'm a bit surprised he didn't run there, but two walks issued in the inning by Landrino, who's now walked three. So not as sharp as he was a week ago when he shut out Jesuit, and now two on, one out.
But really good at bat there by Mason. The foul off a couple balls really hard. Take some borderline type pitches. Draw that walk, and now Brother Martin set up nicely. First and second, just one out for their 3 and 4 hole hitters.
Stretzinger took a hook, and that is low for ball one. Stretzinger flew out to right his first time, and Burns goes to the mound. I think he was crossed up, Danny. That's one that he actually grabbed at and stabbed at, which I'm 100% sure he was crossed up, because that pitch would have been called a strike had he not snatched at it the way he did, and he goes out to make sure that his pitcher is in concert with him.
Getting everything straight. You saw a little smile there from Ian Landrino at the end of their conversation. Burns probably said, hey, don't do that again.
Yeah, you make me look bad, and you just cost yourself a strike in the process. That pitch looked like a strike. Breaking ball popped up. Short center field, Cabrera's coming on. Shortstop out. The shortstop, Labruza for the catch, so the infield fly rule on as it didn't carry. Very fine. That's out number two, and Chase Dolly will bat.
Well, Dolly in his last at-bat hit that hard grounder in the hole that Labruza made a nice stab on, but skipped it over there right in front of Brett's. Brett's couldn't make the pick, and Mason Bonifons kept on trucking and scored that one run out, lone run of the game.
Here's Dolly, reached on the error that produced the run in the first inning as he grounded a deep short, and he took a good breaking ball from Landrino.
Key spot for Dolly, came up with a runner in scoring position and two outs last at bat. Here it is again.
And the 0-1 pitch, chopped towards short, handled by Labruza. Time to set and gun and get his man. No runs in the inning, a couple of walks, and a couple of runners stranded. We head to the fourth, 1-0. Brother Martin over John Curtis. This portion of the first NBC Bank Prep Showcase is presented by the Ochsner Sports Medicine Institute. Open on both the North and South Shore Monday through Saturday. Ochsner Sports Medicine, the region's most comprehensive sports medicine services. Jay Curtis will start things in the fourth. A 1-0 game. Brother Martin on top. Each team with one hit. Patriots had the only error. Crusaders had the only run. Jay Curtis struck out swinging his first time. And the cleanup hitter for the Patriots shoots one toward right. That is slicing. It is a foul ball down the right field side. It's 0-1. It's a pleasure to welcome to the broadcast Dr. Misty Suri of Ochsner Sports Medicine Institute. And Dr. Suri, it's great to have you with us.
Hey, Ken, thank you for having me over.
And we appreciate the support, too. And I know Ochsner Sports Medicine supports athletics across the board, whether you're involved or not. It's you champion the cause.
Absolutely, because we treat all these guys, and we want the community to be involved with the community as much as possible and support in every way.
And of course, you have particular involvement with John Curtis. Talk about that.
Yes, sir. So the last 2 years, I've been lucky enough to be a part of taking care of the Curtis athletes, and it's really, you know, a historic program in many sports, and it's been my honor and pleasure to do that. These guys are not only and girls are not only taught, you know, the sports, but they're really taught how to be young adults, and they really have learned from their coaches more than just about the sports, and it's really cool to see that and see the kids grow, and the kids are really, they're great kids.
Talk about injuries. I mean, it's pretty interesting when you deal with the whole injury prevention issue and how you can help with this and how you deal with parents and coaches on that particular issue.
That can be a little touchy sometimes, but the main thing that my message for the kids is we want to treat the kid, treat the athlete, and the parents as well, because the parents often have more questions than the athlete and the kid, because the kids can be an 8th grader, 9th grader, 10th grader, and they may not, you know, have the right questions, and of course the parents have a lot of questions too, and then all their questions are very good questions and questions that I try to address before they even ask them, so that they don't even need to ask them because they're, you know, everybody asks the same similar questions really. So the injury situation and the injury sort of patterns are very similar in different sports. So it happens very regularly and very commonly.
Terrific slider by Frederick. Strikes out Curtis, looking his 7th strikeout of the game for out number 1. Sean Bratz will bat. He's got the only Curtis hit, a ringing double to right earlier. In terms of common injuries, talk about the ones that you see most often amongst baseball players at this level.
Sure. So very common. I see tons of baseball players, and most of the injuries are overuse injuries, and you know, the common problems are flexor tendonitis of the elbow, or elbow tendonitis in general. We can leave it at that because that encompasses a few different things. But elbow tendonitis is a very common problem from overuse, typically, and poor mechanics.
What about the range, the age range of people you treat or that you see with sports-related injuries?
Yeah, I see kids from as young as, you know, 6-7 years old, young athletes at that age, and, you know, all the way up through the college and professional levels. And the overuse injuries are really important for the growing child, the growing young adult, especially, you know, in their adolescent and teenage years, because that's what gets stressed. The growth plates are a little bit weaker than the ligaments, and those are what get stressed and can have injuries there, such as little league shoulders, little league elbows. You may have heard of those.
Brett's overpowered, struck out by Frederick. That is his 8th, and now a foul back to the screen by LaBruzzi. It's 0-1. So where's your clinic located? And talk about how parents can contact you for an appointment.
So we're over at on Clearview, right across from Best Buy, and they can call over there. The number's 736-4800, and phone's always open, and we're happy to see athletes of and non-athletes, weekend warriors like us also. That's what we treat. We treat shoulder, elbow, hip problems.
Inside, it's 2-1. Danny, you coach the game, and you've seen a whole bunch of injuries. Most of them, it seems to me, would be pitching-related that have to do with elbows or shoulders.
Yeah, I think the scariest thing right now is, you know, with this travel ball, so to speak, you get a lot of guys that, you know, coaches are throwing them on Saturday, bringing them back on Sunday, sometimes multiple appearances in the same day, and that's just something you got to be really, really careful with.
Absolutely, Dan. You know, the showcase is a problem. You know, it's you got to be real careful that the showcases, they have their value, but you have to make sure that the athlete hasn't been pitching all week and then goes and does that and tries to overdo it because the scouts are there and they want to impress everybody. And that happens over and over again. I'll see injuries of the elbow commonly there because they try to do that. So it's okay to do that, but but you have to just make sure that you're prepping to do that.
LaBrusa called out on strikes as Frederick strikes off the side. He's got 9 strikeouts in the game. Dr. Misty Surya, Oxford Sports Medicine Institute, thank you so much for joining us. Thank you for your support. Keep up the great work.
Thank you, guys. Have a good game tonight.
You got it. Bottom of the forthcoming, 1-0 Crusaders on the first NBC Bank Draft Showcase. For all the latest news on high school, college, and pro sports in Louisiana, be sure to visit SportsNola.com. SportsNola features a team of area writers offering unique opinions. Plus, catch our first NBC video updates. It's all at SportsNola.com. Pop foul back and out of play. Good swing by Kirsch to start the fourth. Speaking of MASH, stay tuned. MASH follows us. Can't go wrong there. 0-1 to Kirsch, who popped to the pitcher his first time. And a good breaking ball. Strike call from Landrino to get ahead of Kirsch. 0-2, his 54th pitch of the game. He's walked 3. He struck out 1. And finds his team down 1-0. Landrino delivers on the outer edge, missing with a fastball. 1-2. Just off the plate. Good call. 1-2 the count. Good discipline by Kirsch to lay off. And another. Breaker. Down and out. 2-2.
And you can see why Landrino is so effective. He was able to shut out a team like Jesuit in the district openers because he can put the ball where he wants it. He can locate. He can change speeds. Does a nice job.
And here is the 2-2 pitch. Breaking ball. Beat hard. Base hit left. Boy, he hung beautifully on that breaking ball. He's been getting a ton of those this year, struggling with it, but he kept that front foot and front side in that time, Danny, something we've noted he's had some issues with lately, and that is the result you get. Spanked it hard.
Breaking ball hung out over the plate. Good job. His hands back and driving it into left field for a single. Brother Martin with the leadoff man on, but that's going to be really important for him and for any good hitter at the high school level. You know, normally if you're a good high school hitter, you're going to see breaking balls, you're going to see fastballs away, further away. You've got to do a good job of staying back, got to do a good job of staying with good pitches, and you've got to be willing to hit the ball to the opposite field.
Ball outside, 1-0 as Kirsch is on at first. Hassan popped to second his first time. Kirsch can run, so Brother Martin's been aggressive in this game. And a throw to first as Curtis is cognizant of that. Kirsch 3 stolen bases in as many attempts on the season. And they've got Tassan slightly to pull. Another quick throw to first. Brett applies a hard tag, doesn't he? He swipes that thing pretty quickly.
Leaves a mark,
which
huh?
means hard, yeah. And he's 6'5". I think somewhere along the line somebody's called him Stretch. Down and out, 2-0. I would think that Mike Kreitzer's looking at Gretz and saying, hey, man, what about basketball, right? 2-0 the count. Throw to first, runner back.
Low post, feed it to him.
2 balls and no strikes on Tassin. Another. And that is a strike at the knees, 2-1.
Curtis with a little action down in their bullpen. Can't really make out who it is. But they, you know, they're prepared if they need to make a move, if this inning starts to slip away a little bit.
And another move to first. And again, he's back.
That's the thing about managing this game. You've always got to be thinking ahead. If you're not thinking ahead, you get caught without having a guy ready, you can be in trouble.
Missing down and in, 3-1. We noted the standings at the start. Well, Holy Cross is still unbeaten. They won again. They beat Shaw 5-2. So Holy Cross off to a great start in this league, as they were last year, Danny.
They did. They got off to an outstanding start. Undefeated first round.
And a walk to Tassin. So two on Brother Martin and nobody out here in the fourth. And a real opportunity for the Crusaders.
Jeff Curtis is going to head out to the mound to talk with Ian. They do have some action down there. I don't know if he's going to make a change now. We'll have to wait and see. But Brother Martin, obviously, in the best spot they've been in tonight offensively. Runners at first and second, nobody out. We'll see how they play this spot right here, if they want to try to bunt runners over or not.
And that's the right-hander, Nick Wilson, who's getting loose in the John Curtis bullpen. This visit buys him some more time. And it's a maintenance visit. Bergeron due up. You got to believe they're going to put the bunt on here. We'll see in this situation. Look, Blair Frederick doesn't need much. Based on the way he's throwing, one run could be enough. But Brother Martin knows that they'd like to get him another run or two here to give him some more to work with against a good Curtis offense. As Curtis can swing the bats. They could last year, and they're hitting 293 again this year as a team. That was a long visit. Base runners came over and talked it over with their coaches as well and returned to their respective bags.
Second baseman, Joel Bergeron.
And now Bergeron with an opportunity.
Andre Rovins is going to run over at first base for Brother Martin, so putting a little more speed on the bases.
So Kirsch at second, Rovins at first. Expecting a bunt here. It's Bergeron. And he squares, and he pushed it in front of the plate. That'll get the job done. Throw to first for the out. Well done by Bergeron. Runners advance to second and third with only one out. So Joe Bergeron has done a really fine job. Singled earlier. Good sacrifice bunt here. Provides an opportunity for Alex Guidry.
You got to love that by Bergeron to be able to step in and get it down, get it done on the first pitch. Puts it just far enough out where the catcher's got to come make the play. They do not have time to look at a lead runner.
Strike call to Guidry, and you cannot discount the safety squeeze here, especially with the runner getting a jump down from third in the dirt, 1-1. What I mean by that is the third baseman is hanging in. So if you're the runner at third, Kirsch, you can take some liberties. One ball and one strike.
And it shows you the respect that John Curtis has for facing Blair Frederick tonight, infield in.
Down and out, 2-1.
Here in the bottom of the fourth inning, they do not want to fall behind by any more, even though it's only 1-0. They know that with the way Blair Frederick is throwing 9 strikeouts thus far in the game, it's not going to be easy to score runs.
2-1, way outside, 3-1. Now there's a base open, but you've got the dangerous left-handed hitting Brady Fowler on deck. And it's 3-1. Guidry with a very favorable count. Bullpen busy. Nick Wilson throwing for John Curtis. 3-1 the count. Landreneau kicks and fires. Good pitch. And it's full 3-2.
If you're John Curtis, you're hoping for a strikeout, a ground ball right at somebody on the infield, a pop-up on the infield. Any of that would work for you.
Payoff pitch. Hard hit to right field, slicing right fielder, makes the catch, Davis. Runner tags from third. He will score. And the lead is 2-0 for Brother Martin on a sacrifice fly by Alex Guidry.
Nice piece of hitting there by Alex Guidry. Man with less than 2 outs. Get the baseball to the outfield. He's able to do that. Kirsch tags and scores. Good situational hitting there. Nice job of keeping his hands inside the baseball and driving it to the opposite field. Got it out there deep enough to score another run, and every run with the way Blair Frederick is throwing is big for Brother Martin.
Here's a ground ball up the middle. Tough chance. Knocked down. No play. Run around third. They throw behind him, but safe there. So it's an infield hit for Brady Faust, who again is such a good-looking young player, and it's first and third, 2 outs as a result.
Brady Faust wasting no time. Hits it hard up the middle. Second baseman Chuck Snyder able to get a glove on it. Knocks it down. Jeff Lupo throws the stop sign on for Andre Robbins, who rounded third. He was able to get back. And so the Crusaders with runners at the corners as Jeff Curtis comes out to make the move.
Now, Landrino battled, but just wasn't as sharp as he was a week ago against Jesuit, and he'll depart after 3 2/3 innings. This pitching change is brought to you by Allstate agent Glenn Liuza. Back to tell you all about it in a moment on the first NBC Bank Ref Showcase. Our new pitcher for John Curtis is left-hander Dax Ford. This is another brilliant young talent, just a freshman. Dax Ford at 5'10", 170 pounds. And again, very good numbers, Danny. Look at the strikeouts to innings pitched. He's got 2 wins, 2 saves. You talk about valuable. I'm so impressed with the Curtis team, but maybe I'm more impressed with the youth that we're talking about. We're talking about a whole bunch of underclassmen here for the most part this evening.
They're going to be a very quality club in this league for a long time. A lot of their pitchers return next year. Dax Ford only a freshman. Landrino only a sophomore. Austin Hansel's a junior. Cabrera's a junior. This team's got a lot of nice players that are going to be around for a while.
And Frederick took a big hook for a strike call. What a way to start him. Shows him a quality curveball. 0-1 the count. Frederick has struck out, and he's flying out to left.
This is a big spot right here. If you're Curtis, you want to stay within striking distance. Keep it at 2-0 as he takes a strike on the outer part of the plate. But if you're Brother Martin, this is an opportunity with one of your better hitters at the plate to try to bust this thing open. You know, 3 or 4 run lead with Blair Frederick on the mound is like a 6 or 7 run lead.
And an 0-2 count here. And they've got him picked off. Runner breaks for the plate. The throw is saved. And it's a 3-0 game as Brother Martin executes the double steal perfectly. That's what they were trying to do, Danny.
It's a great play there. You break both runners. The left-handed pitcher is looking at the runner at first, so he goes and picks off towards first, but you break both guys at the same time. And they're able to get in there. That's Andre Rovins scoring for the Crusaders and another big run on the board.
And Rovins, the courtesy runner. Here's a swing and a foul tip. The inning's over, but Brother Martin has its inning. 2 runs in the inning on a couple of hits. And the Crusaders strand a runner after 4, lead it 3-0 over John Curtis, WHNO. This portion of the first NBC Bank Prep Showcase is presented by Park Lakewood Apartments, located on the west bank of St. Charles Parish. A short commute to New Orleans, Park Lakewood Apartments. Slight drizzle coming down in the City Park region of New Orleans. 3-0, Brother Martin in command as we head to the fifth. Blair Frederick in total command, just one hit, 9 strikeouts in 4 innings, and he throws one just low for ball one to Trent Cormier, who struck out swinging in the second. 68th pitch of the game for Frederick. He's walked two and, as mentioned, has fanned 9. Threw it by him, 1-1.
Now this is the spot right here. If you're Brother Martin, you want to try to get that shutdown inning. You just put two on the board, try to put a zero up, get right back in the dugout. If you're Curtis, you've got to start trying to answer as we're starting to get to the back end of this game.
And now ahead in the count is Frederick, 1-2 on Cormier. He's pitched from ahead throughout most of the game, and it's just been very sharp. 1-2 the count, and another. And he got him on a sharp slider. He has struck out the last 4 hitters he's seen and has 10 strikeouts on the evening. And now Kyle Burns, who grounded the second in the second, will bat. First pitch to Burns. Fastball over the outside edge, just missing, 1-0. Wind picks up a little bit, blowing across toward right field. With a slight drizzle. And he threw it by him, 1-1.
He's done a nice job of placing that good fastball right on the outer part of the plate. He's got a lot of swings and misses on that tonight.
Here's the 1-1. And he threw the fastball by him again, 1-2. Oh, he's had a really good fastball, and his location's been outstanding. 1-2 the count. And missed the inside edge, 2-2. Two balls and two strikes. And now full 3-2. Burns his battle back. Play him straight up defensively for the most part. 3-2 the count. Frederick the sign. And a good cut by Burns to stay alive.
Came right at him on 3-2. Nice job of fouling it off. Keeping the at-bat alive.
Another payoff pitch from Frederick. Foul that pitch back. Challenged him again, and once again, Burns timing him pretty well, but can't square it up. Holding 3-2. Another payoff pitch. What a slaughter to get him. 5 consecutive strikeouts recorded by Frederick. He has 11 in the game and now deals with Brandon Davis, who struck out swinging in the third.
Tip your cap right there. What an outstanding pitch by Frederick, as we're going to have a pinch hitter here. This will be number 15, Austin Hansel, hitting for Curtis. What an outstanding pitch there. 3-2, backdoor slider. Just to freeze up Burns, and that's the one you say, you were better than me that time and go to the dugout, because that's an excellent pitch.
This is going to be a pinch hitter here. This is Austin Hansel hitting 348, so Hansel gets the opportunity, and he took a strike call. Hansel, good two-way player, very good pitcher for John Curtis. Picked up the win against Rummel this past weekend. Frederick continuing the roll. It's 0-2.
Oh, he's just got everything working. He's spotting the fastball. Slider's got really good movement on it tonight. This is all anybody could handle.
And Hansel says, why did you send me up here? Goodness gracious. What a performance by Blair Frederick. He struck out 6 on to the bottom of the fifth. 3-0, Brother Martin on the first NBC Bank Prep Showcase. broadcast schedule brought to you by Park Lakewood Apartments, Riverside and St. Charles County. Good matchup coming up April 7th on Sports Nola, April 8th on WHNO. Sean Brawley-Martin, great matchup here as part of a doubleheader at Kirsch Rooney, followed by Jesuit and Rommel. A couple of Catholic League battles taking place right here at Red Sherman Field at Kirsch Rooney Stadium. Watch them both on April 8th on Sports Nola. The others, of course, will separate on television April 9th on WHNO for Charbonneau Martin, April 11th for Jesuit and Rommel. That's our upcoming schedule brought to you by Park Lakewood Apartments. Glad you're with us this evening. Crusaders up 3-0, batting in the bottom of the fifth with the heart of the order, 2-3-4. Bonifons took a hook for a strike from Dax Ford. Landrino went 3 2/3 innings, allowed 3 hits, 3 runs, 2 earned. He walked 3, struck out 1, could lose, cannot win. And Ford is high, it's 1-1. Would be the first loss of the year for Landrino if it holds.
That's going to be 3 big-time district contests there coming up on the showcase. Looking forward to those.
Way outside with a hook, it's 2-1. And the way things are looking here this evening, the Holy Cross Tigers are going to be in first place in District 9-5A. 2 balls and a strike. Outside, so 3-1 to Bonifons.
Holy Cross had that undefeated first round a year ago, and then we got the terrible weather. Things got delayed, and it just kind of broke their momentum, and they just kind of struggled through that second round.
3-1 pitch, look out, crowds him, and Bonifons is on for the third straight time via walk. So he has reached 3 consecutive times, and the bullpen's going to stir for John Curtis again as Nick Wilson again runs down that way to begin to throw. Leadoff man on, Kevin Stretzinger bats. He's popped to right, popped to short, and Bonifons, a threat to run, grabs a lead. Ford delivers, and that missed outside, 1-0. And time called. Good move by Burns to go to the mound to give Wilson time to get up and throw and also to try to calm down his fresh roller. Want to know the count. And he threw it away. How far can he get? He's going to round second. He's going to stop there. And, well, it wasn't that aggressive in that play. I thought surely he had a chance to get to third. But Bonifons is at second in scoring position on the throwing error. Second error by Curtis in the game.
I guess Brother Martin was staying with that old coach and third base rule, don't make the first or third out of third base.
Especially with the guy we have on the mound. We're just going to play it smart and careful. Out and high, 2-0. Confident that with the big hitters up, they can get some damage done. With nobody out, already leading by 3. There's a good breaking ball for a strike from Ford. It's 2-1. Tapper, and the count now is even at 2-2.
Nice breaking ball there in the outer part of the plate. This is a nice-looking arm here for John Curtis. Dax Ford, only a freshman. As you've mentioned, you got to be excited about the arms that are in this program right now.
Fouls him right side, out of play. Count remains at 2-2 on Stretzinger.
Stretzinger needs to make a little adjustment here. Try to get those hands on top of the baseball a little bit better. Get it out of the air.
And the 2-2. Breaking ball grounded towards short. Runner will head for third. The throw to first by LaBruza gets his man. This is at third with less than 2 outs. So Stretzinger makes contact. Keeps it on the ground. As you suggested, good things happen. The runner to third with 1 out, and Chase Dolly will bat.
Chase Dolly needs to be selective and get a pitch that he can get this runner home, get Bonifons across the plate. The infield is going to play in again, opens up the infield for you if you can hit something hard or if you can lift the fly ball.
Dolly takes a fastball strike call. Dolly is reached on an error, which produced a run in the first, and he grounded it short. Both times he's hit the ball to the shortstop, LaBruzza.
He's hitting the four-hole to drive in runs. Here's another chance for Dolly.
With the infield in at all four spots, and a breaking ball outside edge, strike called. It's 0-2.
Doesn't have to do too much. Just stay alive, get the right pitch that you can elevate, get out to the outfield, something you can shoot through the infield.
Down and in, nice block by Burns. You can trust him back there. It's 1-2.
That's a very important thing there for a pitcher to know that your catcher can block up a breaking ball down in the zone. You're in breaking ball type counts right now, but you got to know that that guy can be a wall back there, and Burns showing it right there that he's able to do just that.
On 1-2, here's another on the way. Breaking ball, fly ball down the right side, slicing foul. And the count will hold 1-2.
That's what you're doing right now if you chase Dolly. It's a one-pitch at bat. You're just trying to get a pitch that you can handle and do a job right here for your club offensively.
Count holding 1-2. And time called. Dolly Stephanie. Brother Martin got a run in the first, two more in the fourth, leading it 3-0 here in the bottom of the fifth. 1-2. Good fastball, got him looking. Big pitch. And that's out number two.
Really nice job there by Dax Ford to get to two outs with the strikeout. That's what the doctor ordered for John Curtis right there. Did a nice job of running that fastball right in on Dolly's hands, froze him up. And here comes Michael Kirsch.
Single to the left side to start a two-run fourth. Scored a run, he's 1-for-2, and he takes a hook for a strike call. Now the 0-1. Down, and it's 1-1. One ball and one strike. Breaking ball, swung on and missed. That one skips away from Burns a little bit, but not very far. Runner holding third, it's 1-2. When continuing to move the flags around, blowing in a bit now. 1-2 the count. And another. Missing high and away, 2-2. Two balls, two strikes. Next pitch. Strike three called, inside edge fastball. Quality pitching by Dax Ford to get out of a jam. Stranding a runner. Well, the Martins left five. We ended the sixth. 3-0 Crusaders on top of the Patriots. NBC Bank Prep Showcase is presented by Gibbs Construction, a leader in the construction industry in Louisiana and the Gulf Coast for 35 years, transforming dreams, visions, and plans into reality. Gibbs Construction. Getting late for Curtis. Check out Nat. Enjoying himself. It's good. Here's a right side ground ball. Nice play by Dolly. Flips to Frederick covering for out number one. Well done. One pitch, one out as Matherna's retired sixth. As Frederick rolls on, He's retired 8 straight Patriots, and he faces Cody Schechsneider. He's batted twice and walked twice, so he's been the one guy that he's had some issues with. Schechsneider will stand in. And a fastball high to Schechsneider. Blair Frederick has been the master of all he surveyed tonight. And at the knees, no call. Good pitch.
He's done a great job of locating. Just missed right there, but just he's done a superb job of throwing the baseball once it tonight.
Got that call, and it's 2-1.
Throw it again.
If at first you don't succeed. Try again. 2-1 the count. Here comes another. And that's down, so 3-1. Well, he's walked Schechsneider twice, and he's 3-1 to him here.
It's crazy how that stuff works.
Isn't it amazing? I know you say it's not mental, but I've got to believe there's something to it. He's thinking about it. Took his cap off, puts it back on, delivers the 3-1, and he gets one through there, so it's full 3-2. That's amazing. Schechsneider's worked the count to 3-2 in every at-bat against Frederick.
See who wins this.
Payoff pitch on the way. Well, Frederick won it. He gets strikeout number 13 in the game. This one is looking, and he continues to just be scintillating. 9 consecutive Patriots have gone down. And here's Daniel Cabrera, who struck out and grounded to short. Good play by Kirsch up the middle back in the third inning. Oh, powerful swing there and fouls it off the catcher's glove. It's 0-1. As Cabrera went up hacking.
This is the big matchup. You know, Frederick against Cabrera.
Just missed the outside edge. Stretzinger tried to frame it. It's 1-1.
Last at bat, Cabrera hit it real hard right up the middle, but Kirsch was right there waiting for it, was able to catch it and step on the bag for the fielder's choice.
This ball's hit hard to short again, but Kirsch gobbles it up, guns him out. Another 1-2-3 inning for Frederick, who set down 10 in a row. Bottom of the sixth coming. 3-0, Brother Martin on WHNO TV 20. HNO TV 20. Fastball high to Jared Tassin to lead off the bottom of the sixth. Tassin to be followed by Bergeron and Guidry. Tassin has walked and scored, stole a base to set up that run. He's 0 for 1. Axford doing good relief work here. He delivers outside. It's 2-0. He picked up Landreau, who went 3 2/3. 2 balls and no strikes. And there's a fast strike to make it 2-1. Taking all the way and trying to make 4 work. And there's a strike called, so it's 2-2.
For a freshman, Dax Ford, a nice looking left-hander for the Patriots. Does a nice job of spotting up.
2-2, got him looking. Boy, Ford with 3 consecutive strikeouts on called strike 3. Very impressive.
Well, he did a great job at the end of last inning of running his fastball in on some Crusaders' hands and freezing them up, and he got out of that jam, and there he is right there. He's flipping that breaking ball in at will right now.
First pitch is a fast strike. It's 0-1 to Bergeron, who has singled and had a sacrifice bunt.
There's that fastball again that he does a nice job of running right in on the right-handed hitter's hands.
Good breaking ball. Boy, it's good movement on that pitch. Missing inside, though, and it's 1-1. Now the 1-1 pitch. And a breaking ball just missed the outer edge. It's 2-1. They got Austin Hansel, who's a sophomore, looking at their roster. Landrino, a sophomore. This kid, Ford, is a freshman. Cabrera's a junior. How's that for pitching? How's that for a base hit? Joe Bergeron having an outstanding game. His second hit, he's 2-for-2 with a sacrifice bunt, and he's on. Throw behind him, but close at first, but he's safe. I don't think he realized that ball was getting there that quickly.
Bergeron hits this one a ton. Right through the middle past the diving LaBruzza. And on with one down for the Crusaders.
Alex Guidry will bat. He's fly to right, and he had a sacrifice fly RBI in the fourth. And missing outside for ball one. Bergeron down at first. Ford, a back foot throw. Runner back. Bounce, nice stop by Burns on the short hop, keeps it in front of him. It's 2-0. Two balls and no strikes. And another. Backdoor breaking ball, strike called. It's 2-1.
There's
confidence to throw that pitch, 2-0.
Yeah, I mean, he really throws a nice breaking ball. He throws it for strikes in most cases. So, hey, if he's got a feel for it, why not?
And the 2-1 pitch and a breaking ball, strike call, 2-2.
Got to like the way that he's using both sides of the plate.
Two and two the count. Chasing low. It's 3-2, and let's see if they start Bergeron. Three balls, two strikes. Bergeron a lead, not going, and a tap foul behind the plate.
Went back to the breaking ball, 3-2. I mean, that tells you right there he's got as much confidence in throwing the breaking ball for a strike as any pitch in his repertoire.
Count holding 3-2. And a move to first to chase him back. Three balls, two strikes. Payoff. Hard hit ball, first base side. That's foul. Not as close as a few of the others. Facing. We had a couple of very close ones earlier in this game down the first base side.
Been a lot of action. Home plate umpire tonight has had to make a lot of calls on balls hit down the first base side.
Holding at 3-2 as Guidry settles back in. And another payoff pitch and a swing and a miss turned it over beautifully and struck him out. So Dax Ford continues to roll. That's his fifth strikeout. And he'll now face Brady Faust, the impressive freshman. Walked and singled.
Here's Guidry swinging a miss. That one just fell off the table. He gets the strikeout.
Faust is back.
It was there and then it wasn't.
Hate when that happens, right? Good breaking ball from Ford for a strike.
These Brother Martin hitters getting a steady diet of the old number two from Dax Ford right now.
And this is in there for a strike called as well, 0-2.
And that's what makes him really good. I mean, this is an impressive showing for a freshman here with Dax Ford for John Curtis. And he throws that breaking ball, then he goes and spots up right on the outer black.
Runner goes, pitch is a strike called, and the inning's over. Struck him out. Inning's over, doesn't matter. That's the third out, guys. Thank you. So striking off the side is Ford. He's got six strikeouts. Last chance coming for John Curtis, trailing 3-0. If you are interested in purchasing a DVD copy of today's game, send an email to prep@sportsnola.com or call our offices at 504-681-0120 during normal business hours. You will receive a reply with more information on purchasing DVDs. Last chance for John Curtis, trailing Brother Martin 3-0 behind an incredible effort by Blair Frederick, who's thrown 92 pitches. He's walked two, struck out 13 in the game, allowed just one hit. It was a well-struck double, but that's it. He's been terrific.
He's been outstanding. You see why he's going to pitch at one of the premier programs in the country in Baton Rouge at LSU. He could be thrown in the bullpen or midweek right now.
And he gets ahead of Curtis with the strike, 0-1 with his 93rd pitch. Jay Curtis has batted twice, struck out swinging, struck out looking, and took one back to the screen. We haven't seen much of that in this game. It's 1-1. Curtis back in. Here's the 1-1 pitch. Missing down and out, 2-1. It's tough times for Jay Curtis. He's such a good young man and a good player. Just a sophomore, but he'll be relocating after this year to join his father and his family. As we mentioned earlier, Johnny now at Ball State with Mike New. It's 3-1. Johnny watching this game. And we miss you, Johnny. Strange not seeing you down on that field wearing the blue and red. Here's the 3-1, and ball four, so Jay Curtis gets a walk. Only the third issued by Frederick. This one's not done yet. And here's Sean Bratz, who had the ringing double earlier, the only hit of the game for the Patriots.
So one thing you know about John Curtis in any sport, they're not going to stop fighting until
Cade Como's going to run it first.
Out is made in a game, or that... You know, that clock ticks down to the final zeros. I mean, John Curtis is going to fight. They've done a great job of winning close games thus far in district play against some really good opponents. So these last three outs that Brother Martin's got to get are going to be tough.
Hard hit ball left side. Kirsch knocks it down. He'll go across the diamond. That's what the strong arm will do for you. Nice play by Kirsch. Not a whole lot of guys at this level will make that play.
Really nice throw there by Michael Kirsch, because once again, Brett's hits that one a ton. He's able to glove it with the backhand, picks it up, stayed right by him. That was the key there, and uses that strong arm to get the out.
One gone. This is straight up, back and out of play. Off of the bat of LaBruzza, who's flying to right and struck out. Crusaders are two outs from a win, I should say. Breaking ball low, good take. 1-1. LaBruza trying to do some damage. He's driven in 13 runs. Runner in scoring position. Took it down and out. It's 2-1. Hard hit ball, fair, inside of third. Down into the corner. Curtis is going to get on the board. On his way in, scoring on the play from the Patriots is Como. And it's a 3-1 game as Jordan LaBruza drives in his 14th run of the year. And the leadoff walk comes home to roost, and the bullpen is busy for Brother Martin. And here comes Mark Wisniewski as the tying run is going to come to the plate.
This ball's hit a ton right down the third baseline. Is Curtis waving the runner in for the first run of the night. And as I just mentioned, these last three outs that you're going to have to get will be the toughest of the night, no doubt about it.
Keegan Gillies throwing in the Brother Martin bullpen along with Corey Cook. So Gillies and Cook up throwing for Brother Martin and the visit at the mound. Curtis, a really good hitting team, and they weren't going to go away as LaBruza drives in his 14th run of the year to make it 3-1. Mark Wisniewski, after his visit, is heading back to the dugout. Jeff Curtis talking with the home plate umpire. As the Patriots will get the tying run of the play with one out. And we're going to get a pinch hitter, it appears. It's going to be Nick Wilson to hit for Cormier, who was 0-2 with a pair of strikeouts. So Nick Wilson getting the opportunity here. He had been throwing in the bullpen earlier. Wilson took a fast strike. So Nick Wilson batting 167 with four RBI. Just missed the inside edge. It's 1-1.
Never easy to come off the bench and pinch hit, especially when Blair Frederick's on the mound for the other team.
Hard hit ball to third. This could end it. Throw to second. That's one. Relay to first. And the Brother Martin Crusaders have defeated the John Curtis Patriots by the score of 3-1 here this evening. Well turned by Bonifons and Bergeron. The Bees have it. Blair, Bonifons, Bergeron, Brother Martin. And a victory, 3-1 for the Crusaders over the Patriots as we watch it again around the horn. Back to our post-game show in a moment on the first NBC Bank Rep Showcase.